second largest circulation in Sri Lanka. Okay. Goenkaji, what is, in your opinion, what is the significance of the 2550th Buddha Jayanti?
Well, it is a very important year because the first Buddha Sasana of 2500 years ended 50 years back, and now the second Buddha Sasana has started, and this is the 50th year of the second Buddha Sasana, a very important period where the Buddha teaching will again arise and spread around the world.
There are various beliefs as to how long the Buddha Sasana will last. I think in Sri Lanka we believe that it will last for 5,000 years. And I've heard of another belief that it will last for 10,000 years. What is your opinion on that?
Well, so long as it is working now, why we worry about the future? It may last forever, it may last for 2,500 years. But it gives result here and now, which is more important for us, which was lost. The real benefit of Buddha's teaching was lost. Now it has started again, giving results. That is much more important.
And that is vipassana, is it?
That is vipassana, certainly.
Yes. And you have said that vipassana is a practical quintessence of the Buddha's teaching, and also that it is of all religions.
Yes, it is for all religion. People from every religion can practice it and are practicing now. There is no religion in the world whose followers are not attending vipassana meditation, because Buddha's teaching is so non-sectarian, it is so universal, result-oriented. No blind faith is involved. You practice, you experience the truth, and then only you believe it. This is the teaching of Buddha. It gives result, so people accept it easily.
Have you been inspired by other religions in your vipassana teaching?
That's what I say. Other religion. There is no religion in the world today whose followers are not accepting vipassana. In vipassana centers, people come from different religions and they participate. Not only the followers of different religions, their teachers, their masters come to the course. And they are so happy with it. Because the teaching is such. The teaching is morality. Now, which religion in the world will be against morality? Every religion wants people to live a moral life. And how to live a moral life? You must be master of your own mind. You must be able to control your mind. And this is what the technique teaches, how to control the mind. And in a very scientific way, non-sectarian way, you observe your respiration. Respiration is respiration. You can't give any label to it. You can't say this is Buddhist respiration, or Hindu respiration, or Christian respiration. Breath coming in, breath going out, you just observe it. No verbalization, no visualization, just breath, mere breath. People accept it. And when vipassana starts, then throughout the body you have got sensations which are related to your mind, your mental impurities. You generate any impurity, there is a sensation in the body. Now you start experiencing it, and you find you feel so miserable because of the impurity that I have generated. And they start coming out of that impurity and start living a better life, healthier life, peaceful life, for all the same. Same result for everybody.
My sister has actually followed the course, the 10-day course in Kandy. And she was saying how first few days it becomes very difficult. The body, there's so much pain in the body and
naturally,
it's unbearable.
Naturally, as I say, the sensation that you experience are manifestation of the impurities that you have accumulated. So if the impurity is such that it starts manifesting itself as pain, pressure, heaviness, heat, you bear it, you observe it. This is not permanent, it's not eternal. And you keep on observing with equanimity, it becomes weaker, 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 passes away. You are free from it. Good that it comes upon the surface to pass away.
She said at the end of the course then she felt so much
and
better.
And it's good because when the impurity go away, you feel very good. But when the impurities are coming out, naturally it is unpleasant. You cut open a wound, pus starts coming out. Only pus will come out of the wound, not rose water. You have accumulated pus, so the pus starts coming out. when it goes away, you are free from it. You are a happy person.
Do you hope to introduce a 6-day course here also? Is there any possibility?
Well, there is a center here, another center is coming up, and 10-day courses are being given there. Anybody can join. There is no restriction. Anyone can join in the course, so long as there is accommodation available. You can join there. 1-day course that is being given is only for the old students. A new student cannot get anything in 1 day. 10 days is the minimum period required to understand and to work on this technique. Well, if people get established in 10 days, then they take 20-day course, they take 30-day course, they take 45-day course, they take 60-day course, and maybe in future we may give a 90-day course. So people go deeper and deeper and deeper to eradicate the impurity at the deepest level of the mind, at the root level of the mind, to purify the mind. It is essential, and people are happy to do that. There are long queues even for long courses. We can't accommodate everybody.
Yes. Even in Kandy there are lots of
those. Well, in Kandy I think, yes, we have started 30 days and 45 days, but not yet 60 days. It will start.
And the Dharma Sobha place, how do you name the places? Dharma Sobha is the...
Well, I give name as I feel about the place. What description was given to me was beautiful. The entire Sri Lanka is a beautiful island. And when they talked about this place, it was so, so far, beautiful, gracious.
You have attended the United Nations World Peace Summit. So, in your opinion, what is the best solution to the problems that we face in Sri Lanka?
For everybody, Vipassana is the best solution, and I would say the only solution.
In relation to establishing peace?
Yes, for everybody. In every situation, if your mind is agitated, if you are miserable yourself, how can you find a solution for the problem? Your mind is so agitated. If the mind becomes calm, tranquil, transparent, pure, then whatever decision you make will be a good decision, healthy decision, right decision. But the mind must be calm and pure, and this is what Vipassana teaches.
So all our leaders should follow a course.
Well, we cannot force the leaders to come, but they are welcome. And a number of leaders are coming in India and other places I have seen. And they are happy about it. And people from different communities, different religions, different countries, they come and they get the same result. Buddha's teaching is so universal, so non-sectarian. People don't feel that it is something foreign or something belonging to other religion. They say, oh, it is the same as our religion. A number of Christian missionaries came, the first missionary group that came, there was a very elderly mother superior. At the end of the course, she says, Goenka, you are teaching Christianity in the name of Buddha. I am teaching Dhamma, which is for all.
I think in Sri Lanka also our bosses should be encouraged to give leave, paid leave to attend the courses.
Well, when they will start realizing that it gives real result, the administration becomes better. Most of the officers in administration, they are full of tension, so much responsibility. If they get peace of mind, they can work much better, and better results will start coming. And a time will come when the government here will also give leave with pay for the officers, and not only officers, all the employees to go and take a 10-day course.
Have there been any private companies taking courses?
Oh, number of them. Executives, not only government executives, but business executives, large number of them are coming.
In India, especially.
In India, also in other places. There was an executive course in America. A number of executives of different companies, they came, participated. They were happy.
Before you took to Vipassana, your website says that you were very short-tempered, egoistic, and that you made yourself and others around you miserable.
Yes, a short-tempered person is always miserable. How can he be happy? So I was a very miserable person, and when I got Dhamma, not that in 10 days all my misery went away, but it started getting diminishing. The negativities in the mind became less. I was a happier person.
So it wasn't a difficult decision to leave that life, leave industry?
No, I still carried on my responsibility as a householder. I looked after my family, I looked after my business, my industry, and yet I kept on progressing in Dhamma. A time came when my teacher found that I am fit to teach others, and he appointed me a teacher. And so I came to India and started teaching. Then I was out of business. No business responsibility. 100% time is given only to spread of Vipassana.
How would you describe yourself now?
I describe myself as Goenka, a human being, a good human being. I am happy and I make others happy.
In your assessment, what has been the level of progress among students in Sri Lanka? If you can call them students. What are the reports you have received of progress here?
Everywhere, the same thing. There is not a single person, millions of people have taken Vipassana courses, not a single person has come and reported to me or to anyone else that they wasted their 10 days. Everyone gets benefit, small or more, according to the effort one makes. The technique is the same for everyone. Those who practice, they get benefit out of it. Nobody has complained. Here also, nobody has complained.
And people who follow it, they think about taking the longer course.
Yes, we don't give longer course to anybody who asks that. We just examine if one is fit to take a longer course. One must have taken more courses, 10-day courses, must have been practicing every day, morning and evening. Some change in the life for better, and then one must go deeper to make further changes in life. So not everybody is given long courses. We examine them, we find that one is suitable, then we give them long courses.
There is a tendency for people to run away also, isn't there, in the middle of a course, and sometimes when it's very difficult.
Again, I can follow. There are people
who run away. I don't know, they want to run away. I don't know if they actually do run away.
But can't help it. If somebody wants to go, we can't tie him, keep him. If somebody wants to go, let him go.
They're free to
go.
But
they are very few. Very few. Good. You are happy, I am happy.
Thank you very much.
Be happy. Take a 10-day course. You have taken so much of my time, so you must give some time to me. Give 10 days of your time.